a new identification algorithm for microplastics. Sorry. The software is still in development to become a real product, and I will only talk about the identification process. And of course, we also work on the quantification part. So, due to the global contamination of our environment with plastic, we need to monitor the pollution and especially the marine pollution to discover the unknown fate of the microplastic, what affects the marine food chain and life, and potentially also the human health. This pie diagram is showing the global plastic production ratio, and you see the main contributors like polypropylene over here, polyethylene, PVC or polystyrene, etc. So we need to have a method to identify and quantify all these waste microplastic in various kinds of environmental matrices. So in 2017, Barbara Scholz-Böttcher and her group at the ICBM of the University Oldenburg has published this groundbreaking scientific report to identify and quantify simultaneously microplastic and environmental samples by pyrolysis GCMS. And this was the start of a series of papers and posters from her group. And very recently, she and her group also reported on microplastic found in table salt fleur de sel. So, what are the available and frequently used analytical methods for microplastic identification? So particle dependent spectroscopic methods and thermal methods are complementary and provide different information. Spectroscopic methods provide characteristic spectra and are in most cases non-destructive. Thermal methods give characteristic decomposition products and are destructive. I will focus on pyrolysis GCMS with a short comparison to TET GCMS compared to pyrolysis GCMS. Well, this is of course our opinion on that. So, we have a very high proven sensitivity. So the limit of quantification is found to be smaller than 1 microgram absolute per polymer. So what about TET-GCMS? So the TET-GCMS people are claiming to detect microplastic and environmental samples without any pre-concentration or other sample preparation. However, to do this, the sample must contain more than, I think, 0.4 weight percent. And of course, this is very likely, unlikely, too high in a typical environmental sample. Therefore, sample preparation is getting, again, mandatory. So please be aware what they are talking about. So we have an enhanced sensitivity with thermochemolysis. So we can say we have an adaptable sensitivity if we look at PET or polycarbonate. Then we can use TMAH for derivatization. I come to that later. We don't have a risk of segregation, so because we have a direct online coupling versus TET-GCMS is an offline coupling. So virtually all polymers, including PVC and polycarbonate, are possible, and TET-GCMS is somehow limited here. So the microplastic identification quantification software tool as a product is in preparation, and we are aiming to have a kind of 30 seconds ID tool available. So, of course, we can also identify additives in microplastic. Our analysis is quite fast, so about 30 minutes versus about more than 2 hours if we talk about TET-GCMS. So we have a proven instrument since decades and also a high applicability beyond microplastic, so it's not limited to microplastic like TET-GCMS. It's quite cost efficient because the system configuration is adaptable. We have shown various accessories. We also have a high installed microplastic user base already in Europe and growing. And also our system is GCMS vendor independent. And yeah, Frontier Lab, needless to say, we have a very high expertise in polymer analysis using Pyrolysis GCMS. And I'm looking for a new slogan. I can say we are the pyrolyzer people, or we like it hot. I don't know what you like. So preparation of elemental sample, just one slide about it. So the big challenge here that you have a very high particle range and a very small microplastic content versus a high organic and inorganic matrix load. So therefore, we need to consider a proper sample preparation and a pre-concentration sequence what is not affecting the different polymer types. So you may refer to the already mentioned publications to find details about sample preparation, but I cannot go into detail now. So the next slide, this slide is now referring to, the next slides are now referring to this very recent publication shown here, what we have done in collaboration with Marco Mattonai from the University of Pisa, with the title Identification Algorithm for Polymer Mixtures Based on PyGCMS, and its application for microplastic analysis in environmental samples. So for the microplastic, we use a special system setup like shown here. So to prevent peak shape distortion and to prove reproducibility, the glass liner in the injector, shown here, was packed with quartz wool and deactivated packing material with GC stationary phase. Also, a backflash system was also used for microplastic analysis to reduce the analysis time when dealing with pyrolysis products with high boiling points, such as long chain hydrocarbon obtained from the pyrolysis of polyethylene and polypropylene, for example. And Frontier Lab intends to offer a complete microplastic package in the future. So these accessories are add-ons. This means you can improve and modify your system also step by step later and start with, let's say, normal or basic setup first, but also works for microplastic, of course. So this is the flowchart of the algorithm for polymer mixture identification. It's taken from the publication mentioned before. The left column refers to the steps for the generation of the reference, a summated mass spectra library, while the right column here refers to the processing of the result obtained from an unknown sample. It is crucial to find the most specific pyrolysis products, what should have in best case also a very high abundance to provide good sensitivity, what is really not always easy. Also, the retention time indices search window must be defined. So to ensure compatibility with other system parameters, we have programmed and integrated a retention time index generator in our software. Now the two final steps are the calculation of similarity between the two summated mass spectra and finally the report. So the microplastic search algorithm is shown here using polypropylene as example. You see from the top to the button, the tick of the reference mixture. The extracted ion chromatomes of relevant masses, so in this case four different M over Z, and the referring mass spectra, and finally the tick of the polypropylene standard. The summated mass spectra of the four extracted ions is generated and compared to the summated mass spectrum of the polypropylene standard. And the similarity in this case has been 98.4%, just to show how the algorithm is working in principle. So in here, you can see an overview of all the summated mass spectra of the 11 polymers, and all the assigned values are used for the similarity calculations here, or the numbers here. And this table is listing again the polymers, the pyrolysates, or the polymers, the pyrolysate, their retention time indices, N, the M over Z values as taken from the publication. And the compounds with an asterisk are those used to calculate the signal to noise ratio by extracting the M over Z profiles of the signal. So, since I already talked recently about PET and polycarbonate, TMAH can be used as derivatization agent for microplastic detection. Sorry. And this was also reported by Scholz-Böttcher et al. Recently. So two nice effects of the TMAH derivatization are that the resulting chromatogram is simplified and basically only one big peak one big peak, of course, can be seen, ensuring high sensitivity for PET and for polycarbonate. So this derivatization is also improving sensitivity for polyurethane for same reasons. Now, this table is taken again from the publication and is summarizing a result for the various mixtures of the 11 polymers concerning the match quality, M percent, and signal to noise ratio. And the yellow marked findings are considered to be false positive in this case. In this case, the threshold to get a hit has been set to 80% for match quality, and signal to noise must be bigger than 3. Therefore, sensitivity was perfect at 100% in this example, and specificity was about 84%. Now, this table is basically showing the same data, but using a different layout. And again, 11 polymers are mixed in various combinations and analyzed. And the positive findings are again, or this time, marked in red color. And here you see the second part of the table. If we set the match quality threshold to bigger than 85 and signal to noise threshold to more than or about 50, we can reach 100% both for sensitivity and specificity. Concerning quantification algorithm, I fear I'm not able to say much about it today. We are working on it, and it will be a very difficult task when you have environmental matrices. So we check different parameters in the moment, also the mathematics, the quantifier ions, and also derivatizations. So this is all what I can, or what I am allowed to say today. So this slide is now finally showing the proof of principle again in the pyrogram of a real marine microplastic sample here in red, in comparison to our reference sample in green over here. So sampling was done by a dragnet, and they found microplastic particles have been mixed and milled. And the result is that we found, in this case, 4 different types of polymers: polypropylene, PET, PET, polycarbonate, and polyethylene. And here you see an additional peak. This is our internal standard deuterated anthracene. So, come to summary and conclusion briefly. So, I hope I could show you that the microfurnace pyrolyzer are superior to other filament or curie point type of technologies. And the PyGCMS and related thermal methods are powerful approaches for failure analysis and to deformulate polymeric materials. I have introduced the magic chemisorbers. What are polarity selective extraction elements beyond pyrolysis and for thermal desorption GCMS? Please always refer to our method map as guideline and workflow. And F-search and the new microplastic identification algorithms are very useful tools to identify polymeric components and additives even in complex mixtures, as well as microplastic in environmental samples. So, I would say I'm the end of my presentation. I thank you very much for your intention, and now I stop sharing my screen and to take your questions if you have any, and then you can type in the questions in the chat window, and I will try to answer the questions if possible right now or later if you send me your question again in an email to my email address.